So the lessons for the foreseeable future are going to be just real short, and we're going to play games for the rest of it. And these are, I just named these culture lies, and we're going to look at each week. We're going to look at one thing that the culture says, what the Bible says about it, and kind of just how to move on from that. So the first one is follow your heart. We hear it all the time, and I have just a couple of verses here that kind of I think address the idea pretty well. They always say follow your heart, just let your heart decide all these different things like Disney movies and stuff. And I really feel like our culture is very immature, and so I feel like they kind of just believe these kinds of things because they're just told what to believe, and they just kind of go along with it. Like they just seem like they're not like they're like they can hope you guys see what I'm saying. Like they can live in a world without pain, like they can have perfect existence, like they can, be the fount of their own wisdom and, live by their own rules and everything. It's just kind of a naive way of looking at the world. Proverbs 13:12 says, "There is a way that seems right to a person, but its end is the way to death." And then Jeremiah 17:9 says, "The heart is more deceitful than anything else and incurable. Who can understand it?" So, just a few things that we can say to look at that. First off, you change, and so does your heart. So, like, the way you feel about things is going to change. Like, oh, I'm going to follow you, my heart, and start a relationship with this person. Well, that works like for the first 5 years of the relationship, and then after that, it just kind of like, you find yourself in a dead-end relationship with someone you don't even like. I mean, I deal with people all the time who follow their heart and continually get themselves in these bad situations, and there's no way out because they're in bad situations. Is your heart leading you to do something foolish? Like, for instance, there's a lot of people, and I don't know if the story is made up or not. I'm going to give them the benefit of the doubt and say that it is not made up. And they say that they're driving from California to Tennessee and they need gas money. So that would be a good example of following your heart, even though it's telling you to do something extremely foolish. You should probably, for instance, I don't know, get the gas money before you go on the trip. And that's kind of what I'm talking about with following your heart. Your heart's gonna guide you to do things that are kind of foolish, kind of you-centered, kind of not well thought out. Like, sometimes following your heart would mean murdering somebody. Sometimes following your heart would mean, going in just moving in with a bad roommate. Just things that don't make sense. Your heart is not the same as the Holy Spirit. And I think that Christians as well as non-Christians follow this lie, like, super religiously. Oh, follow your heart. Oh, and the only difference is that Christians rename the heart the Holy Spirit. So they'll follow their own personal whims and then they'll call it the Holy Spirit. Like, oh, I'm following the leading of the Holy Spirit. It's like, huh, that's funny because the Bible tells us not to do that. Here's a good example. Oh, I co-signed on that person's loan because I really felt like the Holy Spirit was impressing on me. That's interesting since the Bible says not to. That's really, really interesting. Another problem with the whole following your heart is that we each of us have a natural inclination to evil. We all have it hiding within us. It's something that guides our motivations, something that guides our decisions. It's something that we are naturally opposed to God's ways. It's just a part of who we are. We want what we want when we want it, and that's just kind of how we think about things. I mean, honestly, that in and of itself is the basis of pornography working so well. We get to literally have what we want when we want it. I mean, that's just like the perfect definition of pornography. And so some stories I wanted to mention from my own personal experience with the whole following your heart thing is the first one I want to mention was about adopting. So everybody has this idea about, oh, adopting, it's so great, it's so noble, except for when you actually do it. Now, I'm not saying that I regret adopting, and I'm not saying that I wouldn't, if I could go back in time, that I wouldn't adopt, but I am saying that there's this kind of romanticism with adopting, and it's like, oh, it's going to be so great and everything, and then you encounter all these problems and problem after problem after problem and problem after problem after problem, and it just kind of gets to the point where it's like, oh, Jesus, this is a pain in the butt, and nobody really tells you that. And so there's the idea of what adopting is, and then there's the reality of what adopting is, and you have to like go through this minefield of like awakening to the dream and realizing that adoption is nothing like you intended. And once again, I'm not saying that people shouldn't adopt, but I'm saying the whole, oh, follow your heart. It's like, yeah, follow your heart, but also be prepared because things like adoption, they're a lot more work than, people let you, the people say, and that your emotions will tell you, because your emotions will be like, oh, take care of the children. Oh, the children. Just kidding. There was a time when I was not enjoying my job, and so I had constantly on my heart to move, even though it wasn't the right time, and I had no direction in life. I was wanting to move just to run away from something, you know what I mean? And so following my heart would have basically meant, live for myself, which isn't a good way to live your life. And thankfully I didn't move at that time. And now I'm getting ready for a move for a reason, to go do a specific thing and not to run away from a problem. It's a lot different, and in your conscience it'll be a lot different too. So what is the solution to this whole follow your heart dilemma? Matthew 16:24, then Jesus told his disciples, if anyone would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. And so basically the solution for this whole culture problem of follow your heart is, don't follow your heart, follow Jesus. And I think that that's something that all of us as Christians are called to do. And I don't see anywhere in the Bible any indication that we should ever follow our heart.